My name is Bryan Petersen, and welcome back to Accountants React. Okay, this is a clip from, I believe, Breaking Bad. I have not seen this clip, or I've seen the series, but I don't remember what clip an accountant would have anything to do, but let's give it a shot.
And here again, unreported income.
Must be an auditor.
Next 1 year straight so far. Do you want to say something about this? Because I'm having a hard time figuring it out.
I'd have to have a look at the copies of the receipts to refresh my memory.
Take all the time you need, Mr. Beneke. That's why we're here.
And that's the difference between a U.S. auditor and a Canadian auditor. Our Canadian ones are a little nicer.
I'm so sorry I am late. I got lost. Hey, Ted.
Sky.
Whew. This building is so confusing. There are doors
in
everywhere.
In walks the distraction.
Hi, you are?
Special Agent James Bakaris.
Ooh, special. Skylar White.
Ms. White, you are the accountant of record for
He's
many
not very
of these
nice.
Reports, is that correct?
Guilty as charged.
Well, then perhaps you can shed some light on this history of missing revenue.
Missing? No, it's there.
Revenue most definitely flowed through this company, but it's not all accounted for in your reports.
Huh. Let's take a look. Oh, well, you know, this account here, that is Mr. Keller's account, and Mr. Keller's an old friend of Ted's dad, and he always sends in an electronic payment, which personally I hate because I'm a real paper person, but Mr. Keller's one of the environmental people. So anyway, since there wasn't a physical check, I didn't enter it into the book, but the money's there.
Ms. White, you've read Section 61 of the IRC?
Of course she has.
I did not follow what you just said.
How gross income for a business is defined. You're not allowed to do that.
Well, I think I am.
No, you're not.
Well, you know what they say about opinions, right? Everyone's got one. But seriously, I am.
Look, it doesn't matter if it's an electronic check or a paper check. Income is income. You're not allowed to not declare it.
When I input everything into the Quicken, nothing flashed red, so that's gotta mean it's okay, right?
Quicken. Mm-hmm. Quicken to manage books for a business this size.
I did. Oh, do you guys use that here? Because it is the best. It's like having a calculator on your computer.
There are definitely programs that are better than others. Quicken is usually used for personal planning and budgets. Definitely not for a business of this size. It's really interesting to see an exchange like this between a so-called auditor. Obviously, it's been exaggerated of what they actually are. Some auditors aren't nice, actually. Some are wonderful people. But playing dumb with an auditor, not understanding what the actual rules are, is not going to do you any favors. In fact, you don't get away with anything by showing the auditor that you don't understand how the system works. That's not their problem. Their problem is making sure that you're following the Income Tax Act. And if you're not following the Income Tax Act, you're going to be penalized for that, okay? So not knowing is not an excuse. If you don't know, you always go hire someone who does.
How did you get this job?
Oh, Ted hired me.
I mean your qualifications. What are your qualifications? I mean, where did you get your training?
Well, I haven't had any training per se. I've always been naturally good with numbers. Got a good instinct for them. Right, Teddy?
Right. This is all falling into place now.
In Canada, you don't actually have to be qualified to be a bookkeeper. There's no qualification. There's no courses that you have to take. There's no true defined professional designation that you need to be to have in order to be a bookkeeper. There is the Canadian Professional Bookkeepers Association. That is a real thing, and people do have that, and it's a quality program. But a bookkeeper doesn't necessarily have to have that in order to do their job. In fact, in Canada, you don't even have to be qualified or have any sort of training in order to file people's tax returns. And a lot of people don't understand that. They think that a CPA is definitely the person that they have to do, or the only person qualified to do their tax return. And that's just not the truth. I would assume that eventually the government might crack down on that. But I would also assume that the Canadian tax system will be a lot simpler before a crackdown on qualifications that actually happen. So I guess we'll see.
That's why I just have to ask. You're not managing accounts anywhere else, are you?
No.
That would be a problem.
Cashier at a car wash.
I'm not really clear about what happened in there.
What happened was good news. Ignorance of the law doesn't equate to criminality. It equates to ignorance. Look.
Yes, it does equate to criminality. If you're doing something illegal just because you're ignorant or you don't understand what's going on, you could be held criminally responsible for that. Again, not knowing is not an excuse.
Pay your back taxes, pay the penalties, and move on from this. Just put it behind you.
Hey, with what? I owe them $617,000. What am I...
Look, just figure it out, all right? You just dodge prison. Sell your assets. Get rid of the BMW. Take out a second mortgage
on your house. Second mortgage? I have a lien on my house. I don't have any assets. There are no assets left to sell.
Ted, if you don't pay them, they will reopen the investigation. And that little fiction I just spun up there is going to completely unravel. You have to settle.
Well, that was a little more serious than what I'm used to, but it is a topic and something that that needs to be brought to light. Auditors are not that scary. I'll be honest with you. Okay, especially for an accounting office that follows the rules. We're not terrified of them. They are a pain in the ass, but they are not something that people need to be scared of. If your accountant is scared of an auditor, you should change accountants. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you again.